All right, I would like us to begin today by slowly looking at this painting right here and just take a moment to let your eyes wander through the painting. What do you notice? Yes, sir.
I think that up there, it's like mountains, and I think.
Okay, so you see mountains back here, and where did you see the pig?
In the middle.
Right here? Okay, so you're seeing an animal here that maybe reminds you of a pig. What do people think? Do they agree with that? Disagree? Yeah.
I disagree because it's like a bull.
Okay, and why would you think a bull?
Because the horns.
Okay, so you're noticing maybe some horns on there that remind you of a bull. What else do we notice in this painting? Yeah.
Like I see like three cows there and an egg.
Okay, so we're back here. You're noticing that you see three other animals, maybe cows, and then you said an egg. Is this the shape that where you saw the egg? Okay, and then you see something up here. Maybe this is an egg. I know that you guys have been talking a lot about characters and setting in your writing, and this artist right here has created a setting for this character in his painting. I want you to imagine for a moment that you could actually visit this setting, and I want you to describe in detail for me what it would be like there. How you would feel, what the temperature would be like, sounds that you may hear. Yeah.
If I imagine myself inside that setting, I will hear like a lot of moose sounds.
Okay, so you would hear the sounds of the cows as they moved around.
I would probably hear animals like deer, lions, and I could also hear sounds of animals dying from the predator.
Okay, so you think that you would hear sounds of animals, like natural sounds of animals, but that you also might hear sounds of animals that would be dying from a predator? Where's the predator that you're thinking about? Let's think for a minute about this animal here. And this painting is called Gelbe Kuh. Okay, so the artist was thinking about this being a cow. Let's think for a minute about how this cow feels in this setting. How do you think the cow feels? Yeah.
I think the cow will feel scared because the lava.
Okay, so there's this lava here, so maybe the cow is feeling scared. What do people think? Do they agree or disagree with that? Yeah.
I disagree because I see the cow smiling.
Oh, okay, you're noticing the expression on the face of that cow, it's smiling.
Yeah. I think that cow feels happy because he's there with his family and he's having a nice time.
Okay, so it looks to you like the cow's there with his family and he's having a nice time. And what about this makes you think he's having a nice time?
Because it's running around a lot and it's maybe playing.
Okay, so the way it's running and jumping, maybe it's playing, so maybe it's having a really good time. I want to give you some information about the artist who made this painting. The artist who made this painting, his name was Franz, Marc, and he really loved nature. And he not only loved nature, but believed that people should live in nature even more than in cities. Now, I want you to look at this painting and think about that. What do you see in this painting that tells us how he felt about nature? Yeah.
I think he likes the nature and he wants to inspire us that what it's like to be in nature.
Okay, so you think that he wants us to think about what it would be like to be inside of this nature, to maybe inspire us?
I think he feels happy in nature because, like, in nature he gets to see so many animals, like a monkey, a bird, a woodpecker, many stuff.
What I'd like us to do now is to think about everything that we've seen here in terms of setting. Okay, friends, Marc, was creating for us a place where we imagined we could go, a place for a character in his story. And today, when you guys are doing your writing, you're going to be thinking about the settings that you're creating.